Hey guys, I am Venkat and this is part 25 of Web Development with Blazor video series. In this video, we'll discuss how to retrieve and display data from two or more related tables in a data grid. So here is what we want to be able to do. Notice all these columns, ID, first name, last name, date of birth, email, and gender. These are coming from employees table, and department name is coming from departments table. So basically, we want to be able to retrieve data from employees and departments table and display it in the data grid. In this example, they're only working with two database tables, employees and departments. But the concepts that we'll discuss here can be used to retrieve and display data from three or even more database tables. Now, the following are the three different types of relationships between database tables: one-to-one, one-to-many, and many-to-many. Consider these three database tables: employees, salaries, and departments. We have a one-to-one relationship between employees and salaries and employees and departments table. Department ID in employees table is a foreign key referencing ID column in departments table. Similarly, salary ID in employees table is a foreign key referencing ID column in salaries table. So here's what we want to be able to do: display department name in the data grid along with employee first name, last name, etc. Department name is present in the departments table and it is linked to the employees table through the foreign key DEPT ID. So to display department name in the data grid, we use grid foreign column component. We'll see this in action in just a bit. In the interest of time, here's what I have already done. In the pages folder, included a new component, DataGrid fk.razor, which is right here. And within this component, we have a sync fusion data grid. And these are the columns that we are displaying at the moment: employee ID, first name, last name, etc. And here we have gender column. Remember, gender is an enum. And to be able to edit gender, we're using a drop-down list. We discussed binding an enum to a drop-down list in detail in part 18 of this video series. And then finally here, we have department ID. Remember, department ID is a foreign key referencing ID column from the departments table. So if we take a look at this component in the web page, as expected, we see all the columns: ID, first name, last name, date of birth, etc. Notice for department, we see the integer values, but instead we want to display department name. And we know department name is present in the departments table, that is the foreign key table. So to be able to easily achieve this, instead of using grid column component, we are going to use grid foreign column component. Field is still going to be department ID column in the employees table, because it is this column that we want the grid to bind to. But what we want to display is the department name. And we know the list of all departments are coming from this departments database table. And we already have a REST API service that provides this departments data to our web application. If you're new to building RESTful services, we discuss them in detail in part 5 of this video series. Now, just like how we have these two properties, employees and employee service, we need two similar properties for departments. So let me paste the two lines of code that we need. Nothing really new here. We're going to use this department service, retrieve the list of all departments, and store them in this property, departments. So in onInitialized async method, departments property equals await department service dot get all departments, and then convert that to the list. Now, here's the important bit. On this grid foreign column component, we're going to set this departments property as the foreign data source, because this property contains a list of all departments. So this grid foreign column component can take this integer department ID value, look up the respective department in this property, and then use the department name for display purpose. So the first order of business here is to set this department's property as the foreign data source on this grid foreign column component. And for that, on this component, we have foreign data source. And the value for this property is department's property. Finally, we need to tell which property in this department class we want to use for display purpose. In a real world, a department class may contain several properties like department ID, name, location, head, etc. So which of these properties we want to use for display purpose? And to tell that, we have another property on this component called foreign key value. And in our case, the foreign key value is department name. There we go. We see the department name as expected. It's that simple. So to display foreign key data in a data grid, use grid foreign column component and set these three properties: field, foreign data source, and foreign key value. Field specifies the field that we want to bind to. In our case, it is department ID. Foreign data source contains the list of all departments in our case. And foreign key value is the column that we want to use for display purpose. In our case, it's department name. Now, all the CRUD operations, that is create, read, update, and delete, are also seamlessly supported by this grid foreign column component. Let's actually implement them. First, we need to enable adding, editing, and deleting. For that, we use grid edit settings component and set these properties, allow adding, editing, and deleting to true. To be able to perform CRUD operations, we need the DataGrid toolbar with add, edit, update, delete, and cancel buttons. For that, on the DataGrid, we set toolbar property. With these two changes, the DataGrid is enabled for CRUD operations. Now, when we add a new row, notice we have a drop-down list for the department column. And the same is true even when we try to edit an existing employee row. At the moment, we don't have the code to handle CRUD operations and save changes in the underlying database table. So let's implement that code now. If you're new to implementing CRUD operations in a data grid, we discuss them in detail in part 19 of this video series. To be able to save changes in the underlying employees database table, we need to handle grid events like add, update, delete, etc. So let's include grid events component. The type of value our grid is working with is employee, because the data source for our grid is this employees property, which is a list of employee. And here is the event handler method. We don't have this method yet, so let's create it in the code block here. Again, we discussed this piece of code in detail in part 19 of this video series. So if you're new to implementing CRUD operations in a data grid, please check out part 19. In a nutshell, when we perform CRUD operations on the data grid, this is the event handler that is called. So when we are adding a new employee, we are calling addEmployee method on our employee service and passing it the incoming data. If it is update, then we are calling updateEmployee. Similarly, if it is delete, we are calling deleteEmployee method. And when we add a new employee, we have to do slightly more work. We have to reload the data and refresh the data grid. We're already reloading data into the employee's property to which our data grid is binding to. And all that is left to do is refresh the grid. And for that, we need another property. So let me paste that property right here. And then on the data grid itself, we need @ref. And the value for this is the property that we have just created. Finally, refresh the grid. Let's add a new employee. Provide first and last names, date of birth, email, gender, and finally, department. Click update. Notice we have our newly inserted employee record here. We selected HR and it is correctly stored as expected. And if we take a look at the database table, we have that same record right here. And look at the department ID value, it is 2, which corresponds to HR. Now let's edit this same record in the grid. Let's change the department to admin, gender to female, and let's also change his last name to Mason1. Update. Take a look at the database table, data updated correctly, last name, gender, and department ID. Finally, let's test delete operation. Let's delete this record with ID 96. Click the delete button, the record is gone, and let's confirm that from the database table. There we go, we don't have that record with ID 96 anymore. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.